two, three, Hot pants. Hey, hot pants. Hot pants. Smoking that hot pants. That's where it's at. That's where it's at. Check your minds up on.
And you're asking me how do I think black women are viewed in my society?
No, how do you think black women are depicted or viewed today? What is your perception or your opinion on it?
That's a very, very hard question.
I think there's different perceptions in different parts of the country, you know, as far, and depending on where you're raised.
You have different categories in our sisters. And you have your independent sisters, and then you have your so-called player sisters, and you have,
I don't know, I guess they don't take that seriously. They don't take us as being intelligent and dominant and being able to like follow up with the process.
In the media, I feel like they're undermined and underappreciated.
I think you also see black women in like advertising and stuff like that. Not that I look at it much, but I would assume they're represented.
Like, it's well represented.
So in the media?
And I shoot all the fashion shows, yeah, and it seems like everybody from Joan Smalls to
Beyonce,
to Leaky Kabidi, I mean, you could go through a whole slew of that.
Dorthan Dunn.
Seems pretty well represented.
In.
Sunny days. In fashion, you know how you barely see any black models, or in music, or in movies? How do you feel about why you don't really see that much black women?
I think that's a terrible heritage of 400 years of racism.
I think they're probably not equally represented, and because we live in an extremely racist society. World, I should say.
In America?
In a world.
World, okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty... I've been to Europe, it's pretty racist there, too.
And this is the same in my country.
Where are you from?
France.
I mean, the media is controlled by a machine. That machine has an agenda. So it's like, unless that agenda and that machine is broken, the people will be smarter, so the media won't work. But they're always gonna find some kind of ploy to, you know, take over the world in a sense, so.
You know, I don't see color or creed, I try not to. And I see different things in news, but I haven't read the newspaper or watched the news, so.
I really don't know, I don't watch TV, I'm sorry.
I'm not sure, I don't have an idea, so.
We're from Sarasota, Florida, and people are pretty open and cosmopolitan, and it's a destination for a lot of international people, and I'd say people where we live are pretty cool, as opposed to living someplace where there's more prejudice or stigmas to male, I mean, there's a lot of gays in our town, so.
Just, you know, it's not up to us who buys the photo.
Represented in terms of what, being portrayed in a stereotypical kind of way, or?
Just how we're seen, or the amount of times we are seen.
I wish that the music industry in particular was a little bit more sensitive. It seems like for every song that is pro being a strong woman and being divorced from the stigma of just being a sexual object, for every song that states that, there's a song that states the opposite. So I feel like we're kind of like on you know, yin, yang, yin, yang. So.
I would say Beyonce's kind of broken ground in terms of, we shoot mostly fashion, so what sells is fashion. So when you see anybody well-dressed, that's why you guys caught my eye, because you're well-dressed for street style, so it stands out. So anytime, it doesn't matter whether you're white, black, you know, any Asian, anything at all, it just, it's about the visual style, so it's...
So I think they should push, like, black supermodels more, like, encourage it and rep it.
Why do you believe there's not enough black representation of models?
Because the people that are hiring the models just seem to think something differently about beauty. I don't know. They look for plain, I guess. I don't know. I'm sorry. These are all very difficult questions.
How do you feel about our lack of representation in the media and magazines?
We will never... Can I curse? I don't know how the population feels, but I think it's getting better for everybody. I think a new age is coming where people are going to be more open and receptive, you know?
I majored in magazine journalism and work in the industry now, and it's such an issue under a feminist lens of this, like, misrepresentation of sort of like certain qualities that mean beauty for a black woman.
Forget the recognition. Why do we want to get recognized by... I don't care what anyone thinks about me. I know who I am.
You have to, and I'm gonna go this route, you have to act like those who are in charge or more in charge or who's more corporate incorporated.
In order for progress to happen, you have to be seen in the media. You have to be seen in magazines.
They
you don't think
the
so?
Yeah, they're never gonna give us. We have to start our own media. Doing this is what we need to do. What they, forget their validation. They won't. They want to keep us powerless. Forget their validation.
You know, they're more in charge, you know, and they've been in charge even though our ancestors have built this world. They're in charge. And they're doing what they do, and they're judging our brothers and sisters. And you have to act like they act sometimes.
And there's always crap in the news, but day to day, I find I'm grateful, and a lot of people are too, so, you know.
I think there is a lack of representation, but what's more important is, like, how people are represented. So, I mean, looking at, like, the roles that black women are, like, praised for, so, like, the mammy role, and, like, the more, I guess...
Like, scandal, and she's, like...
Right, like, being subservient and not being, like, strong. And just having like secondary roles.
I feel all black females is pictured and framed as however they carry themselves, however their demeanor and stuff is.
I would say there's a lot lacking in the media concerning the black woman.
Different races, I think it's gotten better, but I don't think it's quite at that point where it's completely even. You know, you have like equal representations of all nationalities, ethnicities, races, but yeah.
I mean, like, well, you can't put too many black people in one ad, movie, picture, photograph, and it always has to be five white people and one black person just to fill in the quota of what it is.
Because there are all types of skin colors in the world, so there should be in the media and newspaper and magazines. Right. I think it's also important for younger generations to see that diversity in the media because, you know, they what they see when they grow up, like little girls, you know, for example, it definitely shapes their mindsets, how they view race growing up. And so I think it's important to have that set in stone growing up, you know, at a young age.
Do you think that when a woman is wearing her afro, do you feel, like, how do you feel about it? What is the statement that's being made, if there is one that's being made?
Well, I don't know if each and every woman is making their own statement when they wear the afro. But I figure for the most part is to embrace being natural.
A statement about what?
Like our hair.
I don't think it's a statement. I think it looks good, and more women should wear it like that, but...
But you can wear your hair anyway. You're still goddess. Doesn't make a difference what you do with the body.
I love it. I think it's beautiful. And if we can be as natural as possible, or just be yourself, is I think, kind of what I like to do, obviously. Whatever you feel like doing, I think we should support other women in whatever they want to do.
I think it's like big and bold.
It reminds me of... the 70s and disco.
Just show like all the different kinds of hair you can have and how amazing that is, and for little girls to see, like, you don't have to look whiter to look good, and you can use your hair in all different ways you like, you know.
I loved it.
You really?
I love you.
Yeah, I hope that you guys would all just have your natural hair, because we're kind of holistic, but all the stuff that you would use is really probably not good for our bodies.
I think it's better to be just all natural.
It's you, it's who you are.
I'm not sure it's trying to say something. It may have been something like a proud to be black message, which I agree with anyway.
Just your style.
I love it. Why not? It's yours. You know what I'm saying? I saw the movie, the Chris Rock with good hair, and I'm just like, yes, why is this not in public school? You know, why are we watching these other things?
I mean, natural hair is natural hair. It shouldn't even be a subject at all. Like, men do it, so why is it such a big deal that women are growing an afro or having a natural hair? It shouldn't be a thing at all. But it is, and I don't know why that is, but it really shouldn't be an issue whatsoever.
Well, that's difficult because, you know, some like to do it to get attention, some like to do it to feel good about themselves, so...
Yeah, I don't feel like it's a statement because my hair has been natural since I was very young. Well, forever. I've never permed my hair, like dyed it or anything. So it's
for me beautiful, and then being completely honest. And I think honest too is another word that comes to mind, that this is who they are. And of course, I don't think that any woman should have to, like, you know, they can do whatever they want to their body. But there's also concern too for what like society would think.
That's good. I find that very attractive.
Do you think that she's making a statement, or do you think she's rebelling against something, or how do you feel?
No, she's being herself.
Our bus is coming. But it's never been something that's like that important for me. So the fact that it's becoming such like a symbol is like very interesting to watch.
I think that it's her being comfortable with herself and embracing her body and her hair. Nope, you don't need products and do all that stuff. If you're comfortable with yourself, then why not?
Like her natural hair, what comes to mind when you see that?
I think it's refreshing to see someone embracing who they are and just being confident with, you know, this is me and this is who I want to be and this is what I'm going to show the world. So I think that's great.
With me, I like weave, so I wear weave. But there's a lot of people who could pull off the natural look like you, so it just works. Ask that question one more time, sorry.
Using our culture and fashion without using black representation in that fashion show or any kind of ad media is flattery or whitewashing?
That's a tough question. There's nothing wrong with, you know, trying to, you know, emulate someone that you admire, but there's a point as to, you know, whether or not, like, what's the deeper meaning in it, in the sense of why are you doing it? Are you appreciating people who, you know, are in that culture and et cetera? So I feel like that's just what's lacking.
It's definitely whitewashing. It's just you don't want to be so black, technically.
Like, what do you mean? Like, elaborate.
So if you see a girl wearing cornrows, bantu knots, African, like, prints, but it's all white people that's in these ads and media, like, fashion shows, but there's no black models, and they're using our culture, our aesthetics, do you think it's a form of flattery, or they're whitewashing our culture?
You can have a hip-hop ad, but you put Asian and white people in the ad, and that's not the right representation of what you're trying to show. So it's being politically cautious and not wanting to scare everybody else, technically, by putting black people in ad campaigns and things like that.
Yeah, I think it's a form of flattery, even though they could just have us in it rather than having, you know, the white people do it.
But I definitely don't think it's flattering. I think that if you're going to use black culture, then you should also praise black people.
Oh, I think it's, yeah, it's whitewashing, as you say. I wouldn't have find the term myself, but I think it's something terrible that is made by the media and by all the fashion industry and all, is that they took only what they want in the culture that they ignored for years, and they use it just to make some money and make some fashion, but this has not anything to do anymore with what it was and with the culture and so on.
That it's so rude, like for an example of what Kylie Jenner did with, you know, braiding her hair and then saying like hashtag white, so I don't even know what she said. Do you remember what it... Yeah, it was just so rude to say something like that and to, I guess, take something that is like very beautiful and like as a, I guess, a method of like doing your hair and preventing split ends and things like that into other cultures and like using it as a fashion statement and like white culture and trying to like make it your own. I don't know. I think it's kind of wrong.
I just went blank right now. Kylie Jenner, for example, like that's fine, you know, that she can do cornrows or whatever. It's a cool thing, but people like say that it's a negative thing because she's only doing it to show, like for show, like okay, you can do the big lips or, you know, do the cornrows, but what about what really matters?